Yeah, I think the movement was to go to more dwarfing rootstocks, you know, to see if we can improve on the output and especially on the class one fruit we produced. That was probably the main objective. And obviously less labor intensive orchards were there. We've got Rosy Glow on the M9, MM109 rootstock interstem. And it's planted 3.5 meters by 1.2. And it was established in 2010. That's basically what we have. If we'll do it over again, especially on these sandy swells, we'll probably come a little bit closer on the plantings.
And your nets, when you put those up, and what nets do you have on here?
The nets are two types of nets. We didn't put the nets up from the starting point. 2 years ago, we in December, we established the nets over half of the planting to see what the effect was on the trees. The one net that we have is it's a crystal net. It takes a lot more UV out, and the other one is a white net, 20% white net, so 10% shade.
So in terms of the nets, what's the effects that you've observed?
It's still early days, we only have one complete season of data, but there's some variations on the two seasons between the two nets, but in general we get a lot higher class one pack out under the nets due to sunburn reduction.
Oh, right. Okay. You haven't had hail on you since you had the nets?
No. I think it's been a great learning school, especially the things we've learned about rootstocks and how to handle the trees. A lot of mistakes been made, but we've learned a lot and we're still going forward on the same track. So. Mm.